Good morning, students. Today here I'm going to start the practical related to Unit 1, Part A, Accounting for Not-for-Profit Organization. Already I've given explanation this chapter in my last video. Today here I'm going to show you the practical related to receive and payment account. It is very simple and very easy. Already I've given explanation about receive and payment account in my last video. So while you prepare receive and payment account, just you remember all these things. That is, only cash transactions you have to record in receive and payment account. If it is given in the question, any credit transactions, example like any outstanding salary, depreciation, these items are not to be recorded in receive and payment account. Okay? If you receive cash, then it will be recorded in debit side of receive and payment account. And related to payment, cash payment, that will be recorded in credit side of receive and payment account. While you prepare receive and payment account, it starts with opening cash and bank balance and ends with closing cash and bank balance. And you know well so well that any capital nature items or revenue nature items also will be recorded in receive and payment account. Either it is revenue receipt or revenue payment, capital receipt or capital payment, all will be recorded in receive and payment account. Just to remember that no credit transactions are to be recorded in receive and payment account. Okay, so let's start. The first question you see here. Northeast Club had a cash balance of rupees 20,000 and bank balance of rupees 35,000 respectively on 1/4/2017. That means what? There is one club named Northeast Club. Okay, and this club had cash balance 20,000 rupees and bank balance 35,000 rupees. Now question arises here, this cash balance and bank balance, is it opening balance or closing balance? So that you can identify, that is given date here. You see, 1st April 2017, this is the opening date. First date given, date 1 given, 1/4/2017. The opening date balance here given, that is called opening cash balance, opening bank balance. The both are given, opening cash balance also given, opening bank balance also given. Okay, now from the following details prepare a receipts and payment account for the year ended 31st March 2018. That means question here asks to prepare receipt and payment account for which year? Year ended is 31st March 2018. That is, the opening date is 1st April 2017 to 31st March 2018. Okay. Now, what are the items given in the question? So let's see. First of all, opening cash balance, opening bank balance given. Next, subscription receipt. You know well that what is meant by subscription? That is the amount paid by the members of the organization to continue their membership. That is called subscription. Okay. So this subscription, you have to record which side? Debit side of receive and payment account. That is the left side. Because subscription is receive here. Okay. So that's why whatever you will receive, that will be recorded on debit side of receive and payment account. The subscription, 3 years given. 2016 to 17, 30,000 rupees given. That is the last year subscription. Next is 2017 to 2018. That is the current year, because here see, 1st April 2017 to 31st March 2018, this is the current year. So 2017 to 2018, this is the current year. The current year subscription also given. And this is 2018 to 19, that is the next year. 10,000 rupees. So all these 3 years subscriptions you have to record on debit side of recipient payment account. Okay. Next point that is given, donation. Next point is given, what is that? Donation received for building. The donation received for building, donation received given here, that means which side you have to record? Debit side of recipient payment account. Now question arises here, donation received for building, this is which type of nature, capital nature or revenue nature? This is capital nature, because donation received for building, purpose mentioned here, this is for long term, whatever for the long term, that will be capital nature items, and for short term, that will be revenue nature items. Okay. So donation receipt, that will be recorded on debit side of recipient payment account. Next is entrance fee. Entrance fee, that is also received, so that will be also recorded on debit side of recipient payment account. Next is life membership fee. The life membership fee also you have to record on debit side of recipient payment account, because this also received. Okay. Next is printing and stationery. Printing and stationery. That is the payment, right? So that you have to record on which side? Credit side of recipient payment account. Okay. Lighting expenses. So this is also expenses. Whatever the expenses, that will you have to record which side? Credit side of recipient payment account. Similarly, rent and taxes paid. This is also expenses. So which side you have to record? Credit side of recipient payment account. Similarly, telephone charges, this is also expenses, that also you have to record on credit side of recipient payment account. Then postage, postage also payment. So this is also which side? Credit side of recipient payment account. Then after this given salaries, this is also expenses, insurance, this is also expenses. So that salaries and insurance also you have to record on credit side of recipient payment account. Whatever the expenses, that you have to record on credit side of recipient payment account. Okay. Then interest received. See here, receipt given. That means which side you have to record? On debit side of recipient payment account. Similarly, locker rent receipt. This is also receipt given. That means which side you have to record? Debit side of recipient payment account. Okay. Then after that is given, purchase of furniture. That means what? You have purchased furniture. That means these expenses. And which nature this one? Capital nature. Capital nature means capital receive or capital payment? Capital payment. So this one also you have to record on credit side of recipient payment account. After that, at the end of the year, see 31st March 2018, at the end of the year, this must cash you have. Okay, so that you have to record on credit side of recipient payment account. Already I told you that opening cash balance, opening bank balance, you have to record on debit side of recipient payment account. And closing cash, this is closing cash, why? Because these are 31st March, ending, year ending, right? Year ending balance, how much cash? 23,400. So closing cash balance or closing bank balance, you have to record on credit side of recipient payment account. Okay, I think you understood. Now you see the solution. Already I told you, just you see the solution. Solution, first you have to write the headings, what question asked to prepare, that is recipient payment account of Northeast Club for the year ended on 31st March 2018. Then you have to draw the format, T-shape format. Okay. Left side debit, right side credit. Then debit side is known as receipt, credit side is known as payment. Okay. Now, what I told you that whatever the opening cash or opening bank balance, that you have to record on which side? Debit side. So first of all, you have to write opening cash balance, opening bank balance. For this, you have to write two balance BD brought down. Okay. Opening cash, opening bank balance 20,000 and 35,000 given. No? Right? See the question from here. You see, this is the opening cash balance and this is opening bank balance. So these two you have to record on which side? debit side of the recipient payment account. Then after that, subscription receive also given. So either subscription related to the last year or current year or next year, all you have to record on debit side of recipient payment account. So to subscription, then last year, current year, previous year amount you have to write, and then all these three you add together, and then total you write here. Okay, then after that it is given donation for building, that also you receive, so that also we record on debit side of recipient payment account. Similarly, entrance fee also received to debit side, the live membership fee also received debit side, interest received also debit side, locker rent also received debit side. So whatever receive, that will be record on debit side. Okay, similarly, whatever the expenses, that will be record on credit side. So by printing and stationery, this is expenses. So which side you have to record? Payment side, that is credit side of recipient payment account. Then lighting expenses, see here expenses given. So whatever the expenses, that you have to record on credit side, that is payment side of recipient payment account. Similarly, rent and taxes paid when a payment, the payment also you have to record on credit side. Telephone charges payment, okay, postage payment, salaries payment, insurance payment, purchase of furniture payment. So all these are the items related to expenses. That's why you have to record on credit side of recipient payment account. After this, one more point given, that is closing cash balance in the question given, right? So you have to write by balance CD, get it down. Then closing cash balance, how much given in the question? 23,400, right? Now you have to check which side total is more, either debit side or credit side. So first of all, we have to check all these items, all these amount debit side, total it, then you will get 483,000. Okay, then you total all these, all this, including closing cash balance, all this amount add together. Okay, then you'll found that debit side is more than which side? Credit side. Okay, if debit side is more than credit side, whatever the difference will come, that is the closing bank balance. Okay, so first of all, this total you write on this side, that is credit side, same total credit side, right? And from this total you subtract all these items including cash, and then you'll get balance, this one, 70,000. What is the name of this balance? Bank balance. That is the closing bank balance. So inside the bracket you see B/F, that is brought folio. This is the closing bank balance. Okay, so I hope everybody you understood. It is very simple and very easy, recipient payment account. ठीक है, मेरे ख्याल से सबको समझ में आया होगा. तो रिसीपियन पेमेंट हम लोग जब भी प्रिपेयर करेगा, तो हमें एक बात हमेशा याद रखना है कि रिसीपियन पेमेंट हमेशा कैश ट्रांजेक्शन्स को ही रिकॉर्ड किया जाएगा रिसीपियन पेमेंट में. ठीक है, और जब भी रिसीपियन पेमेंट प्रिपेयर किया जाएगा, तो स्टार्टिंग क्या होगा? ओपनिंग कैश बैलेंस और ओपनिंग बैंक बैलेंस, जो क्वेश्चन में दिया होगा. ठीक है ना, और इसको एंड करना है किसका साथ? क्लोजिंग कैश एंड क्लोजिंग बैंक बैलेंस. सपोज क्वेश्चन में अगर दिया होता क्लोजिंग बैंक बैलेंस, अगर कैश, क्लोजिंग कैश का जगह में अगर क्लोजिंग बैंक बैलेंस दिया होता क्वेश्चन में, तो हम लोग कैश का जगह में बैंक लिखता. ठीक है ना, और तो हम लोग किसका बैलेंस फाइंड आउट करता? क्लोजिंग कैश बैलेंस का फाइंड आउट करता. ठीक है, और इनकेस क्रेडिट साइड अगर टोटल ज्यादा आया होता, तो फिर सेम टोटल डेबिट साइड में लिखता, और यहां से डेबिट साइड का जितना भी आइटम है सबको माइनस करके जो भी बैलेंस निकल के आता वो होता ओवरड्राफ्ट. ठीक है, तो ये बात ध्यान में रखना. और कोई भी क्रेडिट ट्रांजेक्शन्स को रिकॉर्ड नहीं किया जाएगा जब रिसीपियन पेमेंट अकाउंट को प्रिपेयर किया जाएगा. क्रेडिट ट्रांजेक्शन्स, जैसा अगर क्वेश्चन में दे दिया आउटस्टैंडिंग सैलरी, आउटस्टैंडिंग सब्सक्रिप्शन, सैलरी ड्यू, सैलरी अनपेड, ठीक है ना, ऐसा अगर कुछ भी दे दिया जिसका कैश का कोई मूवमेंट नहीं हो रहा है, जो ड्यू है, जो अनपेड है, जो आउटस्टैंडिंग है, तो उसको रिकॉर्ड नहीं किया जाएगा रिसीविंग पेमेंट अकाउंट में, क्योंकि रिसीविंग पेमेंट सिर्फ कैश और कैश ट्रांजेक्शन को ही रिकॉर्ड किया जाता है। अगर क्वेश्चन में डेप्रिसिएशन दिया तो डेप्रिसिएशन को भी रिकॉर्ड नहीं किया जाएगा रिसीविंग पेमेंट अकाउंट में। ठीक है, तो इट इज वेरी सिंपल एंड वेरी इजी, आई थिंक एवरीबॉडी यू अंडरस्टूड। ओके, सो दैट्स ऑल फॉर टुडे, थैंक यू।